Hey, y'all. Welcome into the Alabama Football Report. I'm Lena Bond. I'm going to be taking you through all the hottest headlines coming straight from the Alabama football program, then take you through all the rumors straight from Tuscaloosa. First headline we have for you. Defensive lineman JUCO product Tevita Musika has officially committed to the Alabama Crimson Tide after a visit to Tuscaloosa over the weekend. Alabama offered the 6'1", 300-pounder earlier this month after head coach Nick Saban said the Tide would continue looking at options both at quarterback and defensive line in his post-National Signing Day press conference. Musika didn't sign in February because it was unclear whether or not he would have the grades. Musika is stout and strong, an ideal space eater in the middle that will add a much-needed experience to the position. He is eligible immediately and has 3 years to play two. Roll Tide Tevita. Moving on to our next headline, Tua Tagovailoa. He is back in practice and he is throwing, ladies and gentlemen. Rejoice, Roll Tide, am I right? So after just last week, he had injured his thumb during practice and it was announced officially that he had been diagnosed with a broken thumb. Nick Saban just recently added the latest on Tua's recovery, saying that he's made a nice recovery from his hand and that he did have a break, but their medical staff did a fantastic job, adding, "We probably have the best medical staff and the best medical group of people in college football." Nice way to get around that one, Coach Saban. Tagovailoa's left hand has been wrapped up the past three practices, but like I said, he no longer wore a protective glove during Tuesday's practice. For the first time since suffering the injury, he was actually able to throw again with the other quarterbacks. All right, last headline I have for you guys, that ECU grad transfer, Gardner Minshew. He is actually not headed to Alabama. He switched and has decided to go to Washington State. And he's doing this because he expects to be able to compete for a starting job, stating, "This is an opportunity to compete on a very good team with a staff I've always looked up to and respected. I've got goals to be an aspiring coach, but also as a player. And my goal right now is to get a shot in the NFL. And I think this gives me the best opportunity to do that." At Washington State, Minshew will compete with juniors Trey Tinsley, Anthony Gordon, and hotshot freshman Cameron Cooper, among others, to replace Luke Falk. All right, guys, that was all your headlines. Now let's get to those hot rumors. First up, the top tight end in the 2019 class. Is he leaning Alabama? Well, we're giving this one two Bear Bryant hats. People are talking. So Alabama is expected to host nation's number one tight end, Hudson Henry, in late April. The 6'5", 225-pounder picked up an offer from the Crimson Tide just last month. "It's crazy," Henry stated. "Alabama, they're national champions, and to get an offer from them is just awesome. It means a lot." Now, Henry is the younger brother of former Arkansas All-American and current Chargers tight end Hunter Henry, and Hudson is trending Razorbacks according to 24/7 Sports, but it is not a done deal yet. "I just want to keep my options open," he said when asked about the situation. "Just because my brothers went to Arkansas doesn't mean it's the best place for me. I just want to choose a school that fits me best. If that's Arkansas, that's fine. If that's Alabama, that's fine. I just want to find the place that is best for me." All right, guys, before I continue on with these rumors, you're going to want to know my rumor meter. So 0 Bear Bryant hats means fake news, no accuracy behind the report. 1 Bear Bryant hat means Paul shouting out Phyllis from Mulga, which means it's pretty unlikely. 2 Bear Bryant hats means people are talking, we can't confirm, but where there is smoke, there is fire. 3 Bear Bryant hats, more probable than not, but our sources in Tuscaloosa are yet to confirm. And 4 Bear Bryant hats means Roll Tide. It is news, it is fact, ladies and gentlemen. Before we get to our next rumor, I just want to thank our sponsor, Game Time, the number one app on the App Store for all last-minute concert tickets, sports tickets, you name it, they got it for up to 60% off. Go ahead and download the app at chazsports.com/tickets. Let's get to that second rumor now. So Clay Webb, the nation's number one center in the class of 2019, is he leaning Bama? Does he feel the closest with them? Well, we're giving this one 4 Bear Bryant hats. Back in January, the Alabama product offensive lineman Clay Webb, like I said, admitted that it was Alabama, Auburn, and Georgia at the top of his list of programs. And just recently, he said that he feels the closest with Alabama just due to all the recruiting and mainly due to the offensive line coach Brent Key. He said, "I talked to him the most out of any other coach. I talk to him at least once a week. It's kind of like a really close uncle to me. We talk a lot. We know a lot about each other. And it's always fun to hang out with him when I go to Alabama." He also added, "Like I said, I feel the closest I've been with a team with Alabama." The top prospect out of Alabama, Webb is also the number 11 prospect in the class of 19. And like I said, the number one center, according to 24/7 Sports. All right, next rumor we have for you guys, Damien Harris. Is he going to be Bama's all-time leading rusher? Well, we're giving this one two Bear Bryant hats. People are talking because it's not completely out of the question, but it will take an outstanding season of almost 1,400 yards that would rank fifth all-time single-season tied rushing to equal Derrick Henry's record. Harris rushed for exactly 1,000 yards each of the past two seasons, exactly 1,000 last year when he was splitting time with Bo Scarborough, who had 596. Damien Harris is definitely one of my favorite all-time Bama players. He has high quality on the field, he's an excellent student, and he's really even a better person. So what I have to say about that, get that man a honey bun. All right, next rumor we have for you guys is Alabama going to open the 2020 season versus USC. They did this just a season or two ago, and we're giving this two Bear Bryant hats. People are talking. So things went really well for Alabama the last time they faced USC, and the programs are reportedly talking about meeting again in the near future. According to radio host and insider Jim Dunaway, Alabama is in talks with the Trojans to open the 2020 college football season in Arlington, Texas. The Crimson Tide won the most recent matchup 52-6 in 2016 at AT&T Stadium. Alabama and USC have played eight times in their storied histories, with the Tide holding a 6-2 record. USC's last win in the series came in 1978. All right, fifth rumor we have for you guys is there going to be a home-and-home series event against Notre Dame and potentially Texas. Once again, this is two Bear Bryant hats. People are talking. Alabama is currently negotiating a home-and-home series with Notre Dame, according to Tidesports.com Aaron Suttles. The news shouldn't come as a shock to you, considering that Nick Saban and Alabama football have been criticized in recent years by media pundits for only scheduling games against major non-conference opponents at neutral sites. In fact, the Crimson Tide haven't participated in any such home-and-home series since they participated in one with Penn State in 2010 and 11. Now, one thing to understand, as nothing has been finalized, Alabama Athletic Director Greg Byrne would not go as far as confirming that the Tide are in negotiations with the Fighting Irish and Texas. The last time these two teams played each other, Alabama walked away with a convincing 42-14 victory win in the BSPS National Championship game in January of 2013. All right, last rumor I have for you guys. Are four Alabama players, count it four, going to be taken in the first round of the 2018 NFL Draft? Well, it's pretty likely, so we're giving this one three Bear Bryant hats. ESPN Mel Kiper on Wednesday posted his latest edition, and he has four Alabama players being drafted in the first round. At number nine, he has San Francisco selecting defensive back Minka Fitzpatrick, stating that the 49ers could take the versatile Fitzpatrick and use him in a hybrid safety role in which he plays in the slot corner too. He's a true playmaker, and with the size and athleticism to play any position in the secondary. All right, and at number 17, he had the Los Angeles Chargers picking defensive lineman Deron Payne, stating that Payne has had three career sacks at Alabama, but he's stellar against the run and is quick off the ball. At number 19, he had the Cowboys drafting linebacker Rashawn Evans, stating, "For now, I think Evans is a great fit and an every down player for the Cowboys." And at number 26, he had Atlanta taking wide receiver Calvin Ridley, stating, "Ridley is still my top-ranked wideout, but he's dropping a little bit. He didn't test well athletically at the combine, and he didn't show off the explosion I expected. Still, the tape shows a player who consistently beats the cornerbacks and is great after the catch."